ना आई विल स्टार्ट द लेक्चर फॉर यस टुडे वी लुक्ड एट द प्रोबेबिलिटी थ्योरी टुडे वी विल लर्न बेस थ्योरम बेस थ्योरम वॉज डेवलप्ड बाई मैथमेटिशियन थॉमस बेस इन द ईयर 1763 एंड इट प्रोवाइड्स मैथमेटिकल मॉडल फॉर रीजनिंग वेन यू नो द प्रेयर प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड ऑल्सो यू हैव सम एविडेंस फॉर एग्जाम्पल a student whether a student will pass an exam okay whether a student will pass an exam to get the probability of this hypothesis there is an evidence what is the evidence if you call all the regular students pass exam suppose then evidence would be his regularity if he has 90% of attendance it means that he would pass an exam that is the evidence and then there are some prior beliefs what are the prior beliefs all the regular and punctual students would pass their exam that is the belief and for a particular student if the evidence is that he has 90% of attendance there is a high probability that he would pass an exam that this Bayes theorem provides this mathematical model for reasoning such kind of things and it relates conditional probability and probabilities of the events what are the events suppose if a student write all internal exam this that week that could be considered one event a student is attending all classes that would be another event and there might be conditional probability that if he attend the class he would pass that is conditional probability probabilities of event h and e where h would be the hypothesis e would be the evidence further the probability this is conditional probability this is computed based on the evidence that is given to prove whether not exactly proving to come up with the probability value for this hypothesis all right so the basic idea is to compute probability of hypothesis conditioned on evidence and Bayes theorem relates the conditional probabilities of events which allows us to express in terms of probabilities we can express probability of evidence given hypothesis e given h a probability of e probability of h where h denotes hypothesis e denotes e represents an evidence here probability of this hypothesis occurring what is the hypothesis I am saying that John will pass exam on what basis I am making this hypothesis condition on evidence what is my evidence that he is regular to find out this probability I need to know the probability of evidence condition on hypothesis means he is regular condition on that he pass exam and probability of hypothesis that he pass exam over the probability of event or the evidence which is his attendance based on this equation this probability conditional probability would be computed and then reasoning would be done based on the values given for P of H, P of E, and so on. And here, this is the proof to express P of H condition on E. How do you do that? P of H condition on E. This we could write as, yesterday we learned that this one. P of H and E, we can write H and E over P of E. And then P of H given E into P of E is equals to P of H and E. Similarly, this also from yesterday's equations. So please try to go through these. Now, we also should express the probability of hypothesis condition on evidence for negations as well. Negations as well means that he will not pass exam, that he is not regular. And not H denotes negation of H, and not E denotes negation of E, and then we get various combinations. Here, the equation to compute that is, then, is P of H given E, P of E given H, and into P of H. Instead of P of E, this entire statement is written. What is this? This shows the positive and the negative of the hypothesis. This is positive of the hypothesis. This part is negative of the hypothesis. This together represents the evidence. And then here there is a proof to, in order to find that P of E is equals to all this. When you go on substituting the values and different equations, you get that. You please go through that as well. Now, P of H is a prior probability of H. It is called prior because it does not consider any information regarding E. There is no information related to the evidence, only whether he pass exam or not. That is the prior probability of a particular instance. Here I am considering the instance of a student. Probability of H given E, this is conditional probability of H given E. And this is also called as posterior probability. Why it is called as posterior probability? Because here this H depends on E. P of E given H, this is also conditional probability of E given H. P of E is prior probability. It acts as a normalizing constant for normalizing, for dividing it and getting the result. So P of E is probability of evidence. This is also prior. This is also prior. These two are conditional. This is not posterior. This one is posterior. The posterior means that we are finding. This is also prayer only. This also should be known. These three should be known in order to compute conditional probability, which is known as posterior probability. Let us take an example. Suppose we are given the probability of Mike has a cold. This probability is 0.25. Mike observed sneezing when he had cold in the past as 0.9. And the probability Mike was observed sneezing when he did not have cold is 0.20. What is to be found here? Find the probability of Mike having a cold given that he sneezes. We have to find the probability of Mike Having a cold given he sneezes means this is condition. What is the condition? If he sneezes, we have to find whether the probability is whether he has a cold. To do that, in order to find out that probability, what is done is we first should write the prayer probability. P of H. What is H? H is whether he has cold. Mike has a cold. That probability is 0.25. Here it is given. When he had cold, and he was sneezing, that probability is 0.9. So how do you write this? Probability of Mike sneezing given he has cold. H represents cold. E represents here is sneezing. He is sneezing given he had cold. That is 0.9. And then probability of the fact that Mike was observed sneezing when he did not have cold. E is sneezing here. He was sneezing given he did not have cold is 0.2. Okay. Now, we have to find the probability of Mike having cold when he was observed sneezing. So, probability of Mike has a cold given he was observed sneezing, which is the posterior probability. P of cold given E is sneezing. The formula which is given earlier is this. Now, the computations are done. P of E given H is 0.9. P of H is 0.25. P of E given not H is 0.2. P of not H is 0.75. This one is 0.3, and therefore here after we put this as this denominator here, P of E given H is 0.9 and P of H is 0.25 divided by this value we get 0.6. So there is a 60% chance that Mike will have a cold Mike will have a cold given he is sneezing. Okay, this one is 60%, 0.6. And then we can conclude that Mike probability of having a cold given he sneezes is 0.6. And therefore, we can determine. No, next one is we can determine his probability of having cold if he was not sneezing. Okay, not sneezing. For that, this if you say 1 minus 0.9, 0.9 is for sneezing. If it is not for sneezing, it's 1 minus 0.9. Is this and probability of H cold is 0.25 and probability of not sneezing is 1 minus 0.375. Here 0.375 is for sneezing. This is one. If you subtract by one, then you get for not sneezing. Then it is 0.04. Mike's probability of having a cold if he was not sneezing is equal to 0.04. There is an extension of Bayes' theorem. Instead of single hypothesis and single evidence, we can consider one hypothesis and two evidences. Not only sneezing, we can go for runny nose as well. H for cold, given he has sneezing E1 and he has runny nose E2. So how do you do that? H given E1 and E2, and here P of E1 given H into P of E2 given H. E1 is for, in this example, sneezing. E2 is runny nose. P of H is hypothesis that he has cold, and denominator would be E1 and E2 because now we have two evidences. All right. And then we can derive different forms. This is another form. And this is the derivation. P of H and E1 and E2. So E2 given H and E1 into P of H and E1. H and E1. You see here, we know that this we can write and means we can write in instead of and, you can use this given condition. Here also you are using condition into P of H. Here also condition into P of E, this first part. This when you are conditioning E2 condition on H and E1 means this will be H and E1. All right. So now if when you substitute all this, you get probability of H into probability of E1 given H, probability of E2 given H and E1 over probability of E1 evidence 1 into probability of evidence 2 condition on evidence 1. And then this is form number 2. This is form 2, that was form 1. In various ways you can do. This is also similar. This is form 3. For one hypothesis and two evidences. This whole part deals with having one hypothesis and two evidences. Three forms are there. Just you can go through. If you have any doubt, you can ask. This is one hypothesis and multiple evidences. Multiple evidences means it will be E1 and E2 and E3 up to EN. Likewise, you also have here H and E1, E2 and up to EN. This is also the same like that, but you have to have here now not only just E1 and E2, it is up to EN. And there is a concept of chain evidence. If E1 is a evidence of hypothesis H and E2 is the evidence of E1, then we have like this chain evidence. P of H given E1 and E1 given H, E2 given E1. This is like chain. So for chain evidence also, if you have multiple evidences in the form of chain, then we use these formulas. Multiple hypothesis and single evidence. Evidence is only one, but hypotheses are many. For example, if there is a sneezing, this is the evidence, is sneezing. Hypothesis will be having a cold or having a fever. So these are now two hypotheses. He may have fever or he may have just normal cold. Or he may have cold and fever. So there are multiple hypotheses and single evidence. For that, the probability is probability of E given HI. HI here I is H1, H2 up to HI. And everything, all the other things remain same. This is the टॉपिक ऑफ हैविंग मल्टीपल हाइपोथेसिस एंड मल्टीपल एविडेंसेस. इन दिस हाइपोथेसिस आर सेवरल एंड एविडेंसेस आर ऑल्सो सेवरल. मेनी मेनी एविडेंसेस मेनी हाइपोथेसिस. यू कैन सी हियर पी ऑफ ई वन कॉमा ई टू अप टू ई एन गिवन एच आई एंड दिस एच आई इज ऑल्सो एच वन एच टू एच थ्री मल्टीप्लाइड बाई P of HI, here I will be H1, H2, and here this will be sum, summation of J1 to K, K, total K number of, if there are K number of hypotheses. So from HK, means H1, H2, H3 up to HK. All right. This is the probabilities in rules and facts of rule-based system. When you are using rule-based system, the rule, this can be written in the form of probability statement in this manner. If 25% of the time when the computer does not work, it is true that its battery is dead. So how can we write this in Prolog? Prolog is a programming language. Programming logic. It stands for programming logic. It was earlier used for artificial intelligence programming. So this book was written 10 years ago. So here we have the program Prolog examples. Please go through these Prolog examples. Like we write this battery dead computer of 0.25 means if 25% of the time. Battery, it is true that battery is dead, means 25% of the time computer does not work. It is true that battery is dead, means battery dead for 25% of the time and computer will not start. 1.0 means if battery is dead, computer will not start. It is 1, probability 1, means will never start. Like that, different statements, probability statements could be written in Prolog form by using these statements. Cumulative probabilities, when you have cumulative probabilities, it is nothing but the sum of several probabilities. If the subgoal of a rule are probable, then the probability of the rule to succeed should take care of the probable subgoals. There is a mean probability, and within mean probability you have sub probabilities. So that is when you add and when you add them, you get a cumulative probability. All right. Then different combinations exist in Prolog and combination, when you are combining two or more conditions or combination, when you specify that this or that. This is example. Compute overall probability for the following rules and facts. Here we assume that the facts A, B, C, and D are the predicates with certain probabilities, that is probability 1. So compute of 0.4 equal to A, 0.5 equal to B comma C, and 0.2 AD. So the solution is the overall probability of compute using OR combination predicate is written as overall compute P, find all P1 comma compute of P1 comma L, or combination L comma P. This is computing the probabilities for these different combinations. So the query overall compute P succeeds with 0.7. 0.4 is this 0.4. This the second one is 0.5, and this third one is 0.2. When you subtract all these from 1, you get 0.7. This is how Overall probability for the following rules and facts can be computed. This is one rule, rule one. To compute this, P1, compute of P1, and this is L. And consider the rules and facts with the following probabilities. See, compute P, A of P, compute 0.8 equal to B, compute P equal to C of P1, comma D of P2, and combination P1, comma P2, comma P. Their probabilities are given. To compute the overall probability, again here 0.6 into 0.8.2. Here 0.8.6. And then, one 0.2 from where it has come. There is no 0.2. There is 0.8 that computes B. There is 0.6 for A, 0.5 for C, 0.4 for D. Here it should not be 0.2. It should be 0.5. B, A, okay, so here it should not be 0.2. And then when you subtract all this from the overall probability and by one, you get this. This is nothing but having finding probabilities through this prologue, through rules and facts. These are rules and facts. And handling negative probabilities if there is not probability. Then you have to write not C, not B. Rule-based system using probability. Rule-based system is you write rules. If student has 90% more than or equal to 90% attendance, and student if sessional marks CIE is greater or equal to 95, then we can conclude that student will pass exam with 90% and above. Like this is this kind of system is known as rule-based system. You are specifying certain rules. If this rule is true, this rule is true, then this one would be true. So here we have a rule for faulty telephone. If telephone is not working, ask the rule is given. If telephone instrument is old and it has been repaired several times in the past, then it is 40% sure that the fault lies with the instrument. How do you write that? Telephone not working means 0.4%, 40%, it is the problem of the telephone. How are you sure about that? From the telephone history, telehistory. Okay, like that you have other rules and their prologue statements. These are also rules and prologue statements. Now, what are the advantages and disadvantages of Bayesian method? Bayesian networks are useful for inferential exploration. You can make inferences. If you have some statements, some evidences, these are the evidences. And if there is a hypothesis, based on the evidence, you can find the probability of the hypothesis given evidence, or multiple hypotheses given single evidence, or multiple hypotheses given multiple evidences, or single hypothesis given multiple evidences. All these inferences. Conclusions you can draw from the database. The advantages are Bayesian method is based on strong theoretical foundation in probability theory, and it is मोस्ट एडवांस्ड ऑफ ऑल सर्टेनिटी रीजनिंग मेथड. रीजनिंग मेथड, व्हेन यू रीजन यू स्पेसिफाई द प्रोबेबिलिटी, एंड फॉर रीजनिंग दिस वन इज द मोस्ट एडवांस्ड मेथड. एंड दिस मेथड हैज वेल डिफाइंड सिमेंटिक्स फॉर डिसीशन मेकिंग, एज यू कैन टेक मेक डिसीशंस बेस्ड ऑन द values that you obtain from using base method. The disadvantage is the system using Bayesian approach needs quite a large amount of probability data to construct a knowledge base. For every statement you have to assign probability, for every condition you have to assign probability, therefore it requires a lot of probability data to construct the knowledge base. That is the disadvantage in Bayesian. Bayesian theory. Based on Bayesian theory, other methods are Bayesian belief network, certainty factor theory, and Dempster-Shafer theory. This all we will study. First one among them is Bayesian belief network. Bayesian belief network is also a kind of model, probabilistic model. However, this is a graphical model. Whereas Bayes' theorem is not a graphical model. It is textual model, textual kind of thing, where you write the statements. Here you draw the diagrams. Bayesian belief network this is a probabilistic graphical model which encodes probabilistic relationship among the set of variables with their probabilistic dependencies. And the belief network, it is an efficient structure for storing joint probability distributions. And in Bayesian networks, only one branch of tree needs to be traversed. In the case of two variables, we are concerned with these three values. Remaining combinations can be easily computed, and this enhances the efficiency. The formal definition of Bayesian belief network is that we have nodes. First important is Bayesian network is an acyclic directed graph where the nodes of the graph represent evidence or hypothesis, and an arc connecting two nodes represent a dependence. Okay, sorry about that. So here we have a graph has nodes and arcs will connect nodes. If two nodes are connected by an arc, it means that there is a dependence. If there exists an arc from node X to another node Y, then X is a parent of Y, and Y is called the child of X. Okay, the set of parent nodes of node X is represented by parent underscore nodes of XI. In this manner, that base and belief network graph is represented, and then joint probability of n variables. Here you see this joint probabilities. Joint probabilities, you know that whenever there is a dependence or independence, joint probability for n variables are computed as probability of x1, x2 up to xn, probability of xn given x1 up to xn minus 1. This is when you don't have dependence among all the variables. Here you see there are dependence. Xn dependent on x1 to xn minus 1. Xn minus 1 is dependent on x1 to xn minus 2, and so on. This is dependent. Joint probability of n variables using a Bayesian network can be written in this manner. Probability of xi is the node I, such that parent nodes of xi, all the parent nodes from I to n. Okay, this is product of all this. This equation is written in this manner. This is an example of Bayesian belief network. A, B, C. Here A would denote one sentence, B would denote another. Take an example of this. Probability of A is 0.3, B is 0.6, C given A is 0.4, and so on. All these probabilities are given. And this is conditional probability table. These are all prior probabilities. These are the probability when A is true, P probability of C is 0.4, probability of C when A is false is 0.2. This conditional probability table is generated or expressed in the form of conditional probability table. Here it is there. P of C given A is 0.4, P of C given not A is 0.2. Same thing you are representing. Actually, this way you can write or this way you can write. A 0.4, not A 0.2. And then P of D given A comma B is 0.7. How is it written here? P of D given A comma B means both are true. 0.7. All right. Then to compute this probability of A, B, C, D, joint probability for four variables, it is it is using this method: P of D given A, B, C, P of C given A, B, P of B given A, P of A. This P of A, P of B, P of C, P of D. Then P of C given A, P of C given not A, P of D given AB, P of D given not A, not B. And this here anyway, we get four combinations. For D, this will be A, this will be B, or this will be not A, B, or A, not B, or not A, not B. These are four probabilities. So from this Bayesian belief network, And after knowing all these probabilities and expressing them in this conditional probability form using this equation, that equation is then multiplication of node x such that parent nodes of xi. So d of a comma b comma c, c a b, like this one. When you substitute the values, this is 0.7 into 0.4, 0.6, 0.3. So you get 0.05. Or we notice that the above result can be obtained straight away by using the following Bayesian belief network for joint probability. This, using this formula, this one can be directly obtained. The second one. Okay, D parents are AB, C parent is A, B and A. This is different. This is joint probability using the formula 9.18. So this is straight away, this is by using this equation. How do you make inference using Bayesian network? In order to make an inference using Bayesian network, this this example will solve. What is the likelihood of probability that a hypothesis is A given C? How do you represent it? It is represented as P of A given C and calculated using the conditional probability formula and summing over all variables in the network. So here P of A given C, this will be written as P of A C by P of C. And then because there are four variables in the Bayesian network that was described earlier, the formula would be like this: P of A comma C summation BD belongs to true false and P of A B C D. PC means ABD belongs to true false ABCD. And when we are substituting the expression corresponding to P of AC and P of C, we get these expressions. A given C is equals to this one. And then we can now compute values of numerator and denominator. How can we compute the values of numerator? Numerator is this P of A, B, C, D plus P of A, not B, C, D. Because here you see B and D should occur in two forms, true and false. This is false, this is true, this is true, this is false. This is false, this is false. This is true, this is true. Okay, this one. And here all the three, A, B, D, three should occur in true, false, both forms. So here you are getting 8 combinations. Here you are getting 4 combinations. And then joint probabilities, if you find probability of A, B, C, D is equals to P of D given A, B, because parent of D is A, B, P of C given A, because parent of C is A, and B is independent, C is independent. We get this one. And A not B, C, D means D, A not B. Everything remains same. Then all this, so the value of numerator is, when you add all this, you get this one. Likewise, when you do for denominator, denominator value is this, and P of A given C, numerator is this, denominator is this. Denominator value is this one, because it is the sum. It is the sum of all this. this one, finally, probability of A given C is 0.33x approximately. Okay, that way, we can, and this example, students, this is an example of a real-time example of simple Bayesian network. You see here, there is when alarm will be triggered, whenever there is an earthquake, whenever there is a tornado, or whenever there is a burglary. So it is same like previous one. All probabilities you can put in and you solve. You please go through this all. And then we will continue in our tomorrow's class, next topic. If you have any doubts, you can ask tomorrow. You just try to solve that example. So today's attendance is roll number 42, 49, and 50. Okay, students, then see you all tomorrow.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.